had some success again in getting guys loose in the running game.
Yes, sir.
For two scrimmages, that's got to be pretty validating for the work that you guys have been doing.
Yes, sir. Like we said when we first came into the spring, the run game was the biggest thing we put emphasis on. And like the whole line, we've been working a lot on my fits and stuff and getting vertical upfield, and it's starting to pay off.
Did you guys notice, at least when you're working with the backs, Marlon had kind of a rough first scrimmage that he wanted to go out and maybe prove something today?
I mean, yeah. Well, I got to give all the running backs credit because they all came out here with the right mindset today, and they were all running hard, coming off our hips, so they were doing really well today.
You know, you guys, orange and white game isn't as much of it, maybe as important for evaluation as these two scrimmages. So
yes, sir.
Can you leave today showing that there is some market improvement, you think, for that running game just overall?
Yes, sir. I mean, well, as far as the discipline standpoint, we had too many offsides, too many illegal procedures. But I mean, as far as getting upfield and getting vertical, you know, that's what we're about, is getting vertical up the field with the running game, and we've improved on that in the last three practices in this scrimmage.
You guys, Tommy said y'all didn't finish in the second half of the scrimmage. What happened?
Well, you know what? As you got some guys out there that you know, they're just young. Some guys, they just, when they come out in the second half, don't have the right mental approach, and that's just one of the biggest things that we're focusing on right now, is just finishing the game, you know. And once we learn to come in with the right mental approach,
what about the balance you had today, passing the ball and the ball? How much better does that make you guys offensively?
I mean, it makes us more of a diversified team. You know, we're not just one dimensional. We can run, we can move the ball upfield and run a game, and we can get vertical with the passing game. As you see, we got the wideouts to do it, and we got the running backs to do it, and we got the old linemen to do it. We just got to be consistent.
How much did the up-tempo stuff mess with the defense today? Could you sense that out a little bit?
It messed with them a little bit, but they did a really good job of simplifying their stuff and holding us a little bit. But, you know, they did a really good job because they've been going against us all spring, so. You know, they already knew what to expect.
What about you personally? How do you feel like you were better today than you were last Friday? Do you leave here feeling better? How do you leave?
In some areas I did. I mean, I jumped off sides two times today. I didn't get as good a fit as I wanted to on some of my inside zone plays. I mean, there's always room for improvement every time you do a scrimmage. I have a lot of improvements to make, but I did pretty well today, but I'm not satisfied.
How beneficial is it to see a 3-4 defense in practice so much now?
It's very beneficial because last year we played against three or four teams that showed that front. Thinking like Alabama, Georgia, Buffalo, and all those guys ran that same defense, and most likely they're going to run that same defense this year with the guys that they have coming back. So it's very beneficial to run that to run against that defense when you have other guys in the SEC and the SEC East that are running that same thing. Florida as well, who's running that. So it's very beneficial for our offensive line.
How complex is that, you know, to pick up where the blitz is coming from? And is it more confusing than going against a 4-3?
You mean a 3-4?
Well, is it more confusing to see a 3-4 than a 4-3?
Well, I think that with the 3-4, you can run, they can disguise a lot of things better with the 3-4, with their blitzes and whatnot, and the rotation of the linebackers and the safeties. But I mean, it's all, like I said, it's all about repetition, and as we get repetition with it, it'll become second nature. So we're not worried about it. Yes, sir.
Antonio, you've obviously gotten a lot more reps now that you've gone through spring. What difference did you feel today versus going back to the last scrimmage 8 days ago?
Just being comfortable with what I was doing. You know, like I said, I had a little discipline error there, here and there, with the offsides. And I did get a good fit a couple times. But, you know, I just felt more confident today. And, you know, as time goes on, that confidence will build, and, you know, next thing you know, offensive line will be elite. So
you feel how things are going faster? How does that help you make you feel more comfortable?
Oh, with things going faster?
Yeah.
With things going faster, you're forced to move fast. You're forced to think fast, and that's what's been the upside for me, is being forced to think and react, and that's going to be the difference in our offensive line this year.
Can you get a grip of how Justin Hunter's presence, just how that makes things work differently for the offense?
Justin Hunter, I mean, when you got Derek Rodgers on one side and Justin Hunter on one side, you kind of feel relieved, and then you got Tyler Bray behind you. I mean, it's just a sense of relief to have those guys out there, because we're gonna do our job, but you know, just being able to depend on those guys, it makes it a lot easier.
And the running game obviously has been a focus all spring. Mm-hmm. What would you see from the running game today?
I just see that our running backs are just playing with toughness and running hard. That's the difference. They're just running hard and playing with toughness.
What's Devrin doing? What do you like that you see from him?
Man, Devrin, looking at him last year and looking at him this year, his body's a lot more compact, and he's starting to solidify himself as not as a scat back, but as a power back, because he's really putting his head down there and taking licks. It's just showing that he can carry the load. He's probably not an every down back, but he can carry those loads. I mean, I've seen him this spring run power and run it just as good as any of our other running backs. So I'm just proud to see how he's accepting the challenge.
There's obviously a difference in size with you and Devrin. You guys come in together, though, in the mm-hmm. same class. What did you think when you met Devrin, saw Devrin for the first time?
Well, the thing is, I met Devrin through recruitment, and I was like, this is probably the smallest SEC football player I've ever seen in my life. But me and Devrin, we have a really great relationship. Actually, our rooms are right beside each other. We're always talking and, you know, thinking of ways to get better, you know. So me and Devrin, you know, our relationship is really great. You know, I love Devrin to death, and like I said, we're always talking about getting better, and that's what it's about. That's what it's all about at the end of the day.
When could you tell me, did you think that Devrin could play in the SEC?
When?
Yeah, when did you first see something from him that said that he could?
When I first saw him return a kick. And out when he it was against Buffalo. I mean, Buffalo, they were like a MAC-10 team, but just his presence out there, you know, it was just, I don't know, it's just some guys you get that gut feeling about. I had that good feeling about him right off the bat, and his demeanor is not that of a 5'7" guy. He carries himself well. He carries himself as a man, sticks his chest out. So he, you know, I don't think of him no different than any other guy. He's a hard worker.
And just one more thing. What do you want to get done the last week of spring?
Just being consistent. That's what it's all about. Not having one explosive play here and there, just being consistent. And that's in the SEC you can get beat at any time. And a lot of times guys get beat because they're not consistent. And that's what we want to be. We want to be a consistent team and get Tennessee back to where Tennessee's supposed to be.
Who doesn't look small to you, by the way?
Who doesn't look small? Yeah.